this lecture, we are going to introduce the main concepts about game theory beyond payoff metrics. In fact, to have the maximum advantage by game theory, we need to investigate three main concepts, which are dominated options, Pareto efficient solution, and Nash equilibrium point. Let's start with dominated options. An option is said to be dominant when it offers the player who makes this choice a greater payoff than he chooses any other option, whatever his opponent decides. Considering our example, we could notice that for player 1, DVD is gaining a payoff of 3 rather than a payoff of 1 if player 2 is selecting DVD. Moreover, DVD is giving a payoff of 4 rather than 2 if player 2 is selecting Blu-ray. Thereby, DVD is a dominant option for player 1. On the contrary, we could not find a dominant option of player 2. If player 1 is selecting DVD, player 2 is preferring DVD payoff of 3 rather than 2. But if player 1 is selecting Blu-ray, player 2 is preferring this standard 2 payoff of 4 rather than 1. As a matter of fact, it's very useful to identify a dominant option, because in this situation it's possible to take rational decisions reducing uncertainty at all. Second concept is those of Pareto efficient solution. A solution is Pareto efficient if there is no other solution that can produce a better result for both players and neither can improve without the other's payoff getting worse. It is a form of solution that considers the overall system and not the single player perspective. Considering our example, we actually have three different efficient solutions. 3-3 is Pareto efficient because any other solution is improving performance for both the actors. Moving, for example, to 2-4, payoff is improving for player 1 but decreasing for player 2. The same is true for 4-2. In case of 1-1, actually payoff is decreasing for both the actors. Actually, 2-4 and 4-2 are efficient solutions as well, for the same reasons. Pareto efficient is a key concept to demonstrate that sometimes simply following the personal optimal solution is not the best way to achieve the system optimum. This concept is fundamental especially to modeling collaborations and partnership through game theory. Finally, the last concept is Nash equilibrium point. In this point, no player taking on his own has any interest in changing her decision, taking the other party's decision for granted. Nash equilibrium point is also the game solution. Considering our example, for player 1, if player 2 is selecting DVD, is better DVD 3 rather than 1. If player 2 is selecting Blu-ray, is better DVD 4 rather than 2. On the other hand, for player 2, if player 1 is selecting DVD, is better DVD 3 rather than 2. If player 1 is selecting Blu-ray, is better Blu-ray 4 rather than 1. As a matter of fact, we could notice that the equilibrium point is DVD for both the actor. As a matter of fact, we know that DVD is a dominant option for player 1, and so we could take for granted that player 1 is going to select that option. In case of a dominant option, the equilibrium point is the best option of the other player. In this case, the equilibrium point is by chance also an efficient solution. This is a positive point, because individual optimal solution and system optimal solution coincide, but it is not taken for granted.